James here from Devoted Gaming, and this is a walkthrough for Destiny. Hey guys, welcome to the Destiny walkthrough. I've been putting off making a walkthrough for this game because it takes a while to level up your character once you're past 20. And you can consider Destiny like a cross of Halo meets Borderlands meets World of Warcraft, so it requires a lot of grinding and stuff. So basically you have three classes to choose from at the start of the game. You got Titan, Hunter, and Warlock. And I already have a Warlock. That's my strongest character. It was my first character, and it took me about 2, maybe 3 months just to level it up to a decent level, because once you're past level 20, your level is determined by the rarity and the quality of your equipment. And I started Hunter, I think, 3 weeks ago, but my Hunter's coming along pretty quickly, because due to the fact that I got hand-me-downs from my Warlock down to my Hunter. So for the sake of this walkthrough, I'll be creating a Titan, because I don't have one yet. So, yeah. And it shouldn't take me too long to level up my Titan, because I have a lot of gear for my Titan from my Warlock that the White Warlock picked up, so I can always just transfer it down to make things faster. So basically, for this walkthrough, I'm basically going to focus on the story itself. And once that's done, I'll be doing a separate walkthrough for the strikes, the raids, and DLCs and stuff. So basically, for this walkthrough, I'm focusing on the basics of the game, and how to level up, and the story itself. And the story of this game isn't very good. I'll explain why when we get to those points. But for now, I chose Titan, and I'm going to create a character right now. And instead of you guys watching me for 30 minutes deciding what I want him to look like, I'll skip to the part where I'm done creating him. Alright, 30 minutes later, and I think I've almost got... I just can't determine his color. I think I'm gonna go with this cameo flush checkered thing. Cameo, yeah, I like this cameo. This checkered thing doesn't look that good. Actually, it's not that bad. You know, I'll go with this one. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I think I'm fine with this. Very fresh finish before it's too late.
We called it the Traveler, and its arrival changed us forever. Great cities were built on Mars and Venus. Mercury became a garden world. Human lifespan tripled. It was a time of miracles. We stared out at the galaxy and knew that it was our destiny to walk in the light of other stars. But the Traveler had an enemy. A darkness which had hunted it for eons across the black gulfs of space. Centuries after our golden age began, this darkness found us. And that was the end of everything. But it was also a beginning.
Guardian? Eyes up, Guardian. It worked. You're alive. You don't know how long I've been looking for you. I'm a ghost. Actually, now I'm your ghost. And you, well, you've been dead a long time. So you're gonna see a lot of things you won't understand. This is fallen territory. We aren't safe here. I have to get you to the city.
Hold still.
Don't worry, I'm still with you. We need to move. Fast. We won't survive long out in the open like this. Let's get inside the walls.
So, the story might be lacking in Destiny, but the graphics are not lacking. It's probably one of the most beautiful games I've played on the PS4 so far, in my opinion. Lots of Instagram moments. Let's just say if I was on the moon or Mars and saw those sights, I'd probably take a lot of Instagram pictures. So anyway, basically with Destiny, if you're the type of person that loves to grind and do a lot of farming and that's very repetitive, then this game is totally meant for you.
Okay, I need to find you a weapon before the Fallen find us.
Because the amount you have to do to get the best gear takes a long time. And even when you have the best gear, you still have to upgrade it, which means you gotta farm materials. So it requires so much.
Hang tight. Fallen thrive in the dark. We won't. We need more light. I'll see what I can do.
And since I am a creature of habit and I love routine, this game is perfect for me because I love to farm and grind when it comes to these games. So that's why I didn't mind spending so much time on one character. Because the feeling once you've achieved something in this game, it feels good.
I found a rifle. Grab it.
And finally we have our first weapon.
I hope you know how to use that thing.
I hope so too. I think this is an auto rifle. Hello. An auto rifle is not my preferred weapon. It's an auto rifle, yeah. I prefer scout rifles. But basically, an auto rifle is a faster version of a scout rifle. Well, hello. And I do apologize for my really bad accuracy, because you know me, I am a mouse and keyboard person. I am not a controller person. Stop hiding.
There's more ahead. Keep it up. A loot cache. Let's
our see first
what's
one. And we got a shotgun, another weapon I don't really use in this game.
Chip mines! Don't touch them.
Well, you can blow them up, or I'm just gonna crawl under these. Stop hiding! Dang it. They're just gonna go back and forth like this. Fine, I'll approach. Punch. And, oh. Whoops. Oh, the enemy troop. Oh, I screwed it. Ambush. Now the enemy AI is pretty good in this game. Like when you shoot them, they will try to move for cover. If they have shields and you deplete their shields, they will always hide from you so they can recharge their batteries and then shoot you again. So the enemy AI is pretty well designed here. If you shoot them, they go for cover. Well, I didn't mean to shoot that guy, but yeah. Stop hiding. Hello. And a bunch of the base.
The Fallen have a tighter hold on this place than I thought. Just a little bit further. Let's hope there's something left out there. This was an old cosmodrome. There's gotta be something we can fly out of here. Incoming! Fallen ships! This close to the surface! Move!
No, I'm not gonna move. I'm gonna fight these guys. So I want the experience, because I'm only level 1 still. So basically, from level 1 to 20, you have an experience bar which you fill up, and then with this fill, you level up. Once you're past level 20, your level is determined by the level of your equipment. The better your equipment, the higher your level is. And you're probably thinking, level 30, that's kind of a low max level. Technically, it's not 30 anymore, it's 32 since the DLC came out, the level cap went up. And second, getting to level 30 is a very daunting task. Trying to find the gear is like trying to win the lottery. And even if you have the gear, it might take you a while to be able to obtain the materials required to upgrade it to this maximum power. So, yeah. Level 30 might seem that's pretty easy. It's not. It takes a while. Level 1 to 20 is easy. Because all you gotta do is just fight enemies and finish missions to get experience points. Once that's over, you don't get experience points. Or, experience points don't matter. Hello. I like how the Titan punches. The hunter uses a knife. Oh, I just walked into an ambush. Or a large run of enemies. Not gonna lie, when I first saw those mobile shank machines, I thought they were Flight Set's game. Level 2!
I'm picking up signs of an old jump ship. Could be our ticket out of here.
Ooh, upgrade unlocked. Wait, let me go to cover to do this. When you pause your game, the game doesn't pause, so make sure you're in cover before you open your menu screen. I unlocked grenades! The flashbang grenade. The Titan's grenades will blind distort the enemy for a little bit of time. That's really useful. Let's see. Or it knocks them all out. I can't show you that they get blinded. Oh, got a hand cannon. I guess that's my next choice of a weapon. But I'll stick to my auto rifle. It's doing its job. I believe we have our first boss fight in here.
There's a ship.
There he is.
Clear him out.
Ron, the devil captain. And he has a shield. Great. Let me get rid of his help first. His shield's regenerated, but that's fine. I think it's on a strong one. Yeah, he's going down. Dang it, reload. Don't regenerate. Good. And we're done. Oh wait, no wait. See, that guy's distorted. That's pretty useful, actually. And we're done.
Alright, let me see if I can get us
out. I'm gonna end the video right after the cutscene.
It's been here a while. Hasn't made a jump in centuries. We're lucky the Fallen haven't completely picked it clean.
Will it fly?
I can make it work. Okay, it's not going to break orbit. It just might get us to the city. Now, about that transmat. Bringing you in. We can come back for them when you're ready. Let's get you home.
Alright, so thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.